And we welcome you to the south side of Chicago and Guaranteed Rate Field. We've got a perfect night for baseball on the show. It's the New York Yankees going up against the Chicago White Sox. First pitch coming your way next. Okay, all set to go. Well, the batter will be the shortstop, Isaiah Kiner-Falefa. And the right-hander deals. Hacks and misses. It's a strikeout. And now Bader up to the plate. The center fielder. The wind and the pitch. Good eye in that spot. See the velocity, 97 with that fastball. The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball four.
Now, this is a story we were paying attention to before the game. We've seen him give up walks in the past, and it's an issue once again early on.
Next pitch is outside.
Good speed on the base pass. He handles the bat very well. I wouldn't be surprised if the skipper puts on some type of hit and run or run and hit.
Swings and misses. Slider right there.
Now there's a certain point where you have to commit to what you think you see, and he guessed wrong right there.
Bader runs. There's a ball. Throw. Tag. Ow! Grandal with a quick release. Now a bullet to second base, but he's got it to end the inning. Andrew Benintendi steps up. Chris, his skill set straight out of the mid-80s. Good contact, not much power, and he can run. He always uses the wheels to his advantage.
His biggest challenge in this day and age is to not get caught up in trying to hit home runs because so many people are.
Next one just misses. 2-2.
He just has to understand that his skill set is unique and he's very valuable for any ball club. If he does that, he'll play a long time in this league.
Swings through it for the K. He swung over top of the curveball. Here's Tim Anderson. Started to go after it. Now a look down to first. And yes, he did. That's a swing, according to Gary Simmons. On the ground, right side. Has some trouble with it. Flip to the pitcher is in time. And they do get the second out of the inning. Two outs, base is empty. Eloy Jimenez now at the plate. Right-hander kicks deals. That one missed. In 2022, Gerrit Cole set the Yankees' single-season strikeout record with 257 punch-outs. Pretty amazing mark for that historic franchise. And down on strikes he goes, and that will end the inning. Top of the second, so now the Yankees' cleanup hitter, Giancarlo Stanton.
Giancarlo Stanton.
The wind of the pitch. Swing and a high fly ball down the left field line, but hooking foul. That's foul off to the right side, keeps the AB going. Next pitch is popped up. Vaughn makes the grab, one down. Anthony Rizzo steps to the plate.
The first baseman, Anthony Rizzo.
One down, base is empty. And that one hit 97 on the gun. Here comes Gleyber Torres. Here comes a 3-2. Goes down looking. Bottom of the second. Luis Robert now. Singy, you can't ask for anything more. This guy checks all the boxes offensively.
He's the ultimate professional, and it doesn't just start at game time. It starts in the afternoon, the way he prepares and gets ready for the ball game. I tell you what, his teammates feed off of the leadership that he shows on and off the field.
Swing and a miss, struck him out. Gassed it right by him. And next to hit for the Sox, Gavin Sheets.
I love that Garrett Cole is sort of a throwback guy out there on the mound, sort of that classic power pitcher. He's going to attack with that fastball, move it all around the edges of the zone, and when he has to, fill up the strike zone with confidence that hitters can't touch it.
Andrew Vaughn now. Swing and a miss. And the count is 1-2. Cole, of course, the first overall pick by the Pirates in the 2011 draft out of UCLA, and really blossomed as he moved from Pittsburgh to Houston in 2018. Got him. The big righty strikes out the side. Here on the south side. Well, here we go. Top of the third, scoreless game. Now, here is DJ LeMahieu. The wind of the pitch.
No, that's low.
The 3-1 in for a strike, full count. Next offering is fouled back. 3-2 now. Swing and a miss. The high heat, too much on that one. Here's Jose Trevino. Next offering misses, 2-2. Next pitch is popped up. Vaughn makes the catch. Two away down. Now it's the switch hitting outfielder, Oswaldo Cabrera.
Oswaldo Cabrera.
Two outs. And that one is inside. High fly ball out into left center field. And Benintendi able to make the grab. That is the inning. Back at Guaranteed Rate Field. And now the switch hitting catcher, Yasmani Grandal.
Yasmani Grandal.
Here comes a pitch. And strike two.
One ball, two strikes.
Next offering, pop foul off to the right out of play. The 1-2.
Two balls, two strikes.
Oh, that got away from him. And he's going to reach on a hit by pitch to lead off the inning.
After all of that, he hits it. Man, I was really enjoying the battle, and I didn't expect it to end like that.
Here is Yoan Moncada. Check swing, but he went too far. And it's 1-2. Swings and misses, struck him out. Some high cheese for strike three. Hunter Alberto up to the plate. And 1-2. Righty to the plate. Swings, threw it, and that's a strikeout. Now it's Andrew Benintendi to hit. Let off the game with a strikeout. Benintendi, the former first-round pick, Golden Spikes Award winner. The 1-1. Not the best swing that time from the first-round pick.
Clearly he was sitting on a fastball right there. It just ended up out in front of the slider. Hey, you can't fault him for his commitment. Now he's just going to have to battle with two strikes.
He's got it. And that is out number three. Out of the fourth, Isaiah Kiner-Falefa up to the plate.
Isaiah Kiner-Falefa.
That misses the zone, and it's 2-2. And another ball. The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball four.
What a battle. It's not always easy laying off a 3-2 pitch, and I tell you what, he earned that one.
The Yanks still looking for their first hit in this one. To third, and it's just foul. That was close.
With two strikes, may see some movement over there at first base, trying to stay out of a double play here.
And the righty deals. Check swing, and he held up.
That pitch wasn't even close, and they still got a check swing out of it. He's going to have to make an adjustment and make it fast.
Swing and a drive. Deep center field. On its way. Home run. He sends it out of here. And the Yankees have the lead. It's 2-0.
Knew what pitch he wanted to hit. Spit on some other pitches in this at bat. Was very patient, and it paid off.
Aaron Judge at the plate. He's 0-1. 3-2. Payoff pitch. Cuts on it and misses. That's a strikeout. Blew the express right by his bat for strike three. And now it's Giancarlo Stanton. He popped out his first time. Hard hit, but right at him and left.
Man, he smoked that fastball. He's all over it. It's just frustrating when you can't get it to fall. Maybe next time up, he'll find a hole.
And here it comes. So a foul ball makes it 1-2.
Boog, when we talk about Anthony Rizzo defensively, one of the things I like as a former outfielder is his ability to handle foul territory and just negotiate that sidewall to make some incredible catches.
Next pitch misses inside, and that's ball three. He's super aggressive, crashing at first base. He's one of the best throwers at first defensively. And, of course, he picks the ball in the dirt. And there's the third out. That'll do it for the inning. Welcome back. Bottom of the fourth. Now it's the shortstop, Tim Anderson.
The shortstop, Tim Anderson.
The pitch. Got him swinging for the strikeout. Slider got him for strike three. Here's Eloy Jimenez. He struck out swinging at his first at bat. The 2-1.
Ball. Well, these guys have had a hard time scoring in this one. The guy out there on the mound wants to keep attacking, make sure that they don't get any confidence. Well, he tried to nibble right there and just missed his spot. Hitter didn't offer at it. Now he has somebody to worry about over at first.
One gone, runner at first. And now it's Luis Robert. In there at the knees, two balls, two strikes. Got him swinging. And here is Gavin Sheets. He was a strikeout victim his first time. And he deals. Got him swinging. Pulled the string on the changeup. Back here on the south side, we go to the top of the fifth. Here is Gleyber Torres. Torres, a guy the Yankees acquired for Aroldis Chapman back in 2016.
He is fearless. You can't tell if he's been in this league for 8 years or 2 years.
Swing and a miss for the strikeout. The high heat, too much on that one. Up to the plate steps DJ LeMahieu. Struck out swinging his first time. And a pitch. And delivers outside. Fouled off again. And it remains 3-2. And a pitch. Slow roller up the middle. Sends it to first. And the first two set down on the top of the fifth. And now the catcher comes up to him. Jose Trevino. First time up was a pop out. The pitch.
2 balls, 2 strikes.
Swung on, popped up on the infield. Moncada makes the catch, and that'll do it. We head to the bottom of the fifth, and here's the first baseman, Andrew Vaughn.
The first baseman, Andrew Vaughn.
Ball to strike. He swings and fouls one off.
You know, these White Sox doing a great job, Boog, of just waiting for the right pitch to come their way, and I'm seeing very patient at-bats out of him. Starter's leash has to be getting tighter with his pitch count where it is, but so far he's been really effective in this one. You know, sometimes it just takes getting to the bullpen in order to be able to score runs, and that might be the case today.
The wide to kick the pitch. Swing and a miss, struck him out. Couldn't catch up to the heater. And now Yoan Moncada went down on strikes his first time through. The White Sox hitless so far in the game. Good eye right there. In for a strike. Now it's 3-2.
Looking sharp, just a strike away from 5 shutout innings.
Next offering is fouled back. 2 down, nobody on. The right-hander gives up the 2-out walk.
Boog, do you think you could draw a walk in the bigs if we gave you enough at-bats?
Ooh, that's a good question.
I think that if they gave the pitcher a false scouting report on me, yes, I think I could draw a walk. And now 2-1. Just missed.
Last couple of pitches, breaking balls away. I think he's going to have to come firm inside to be able to open up that location if he wants to go back there later in this count.
3-2. Swings through it for the K. Couldn't hit the fastball at the knees. All right, we go to the top half of inning number 6. And now it's going to be Oswaldo Cabrera. That misses the zone. 3 balls and a strike. And he pumps in a strike.
Count is 3-2.
3-2 now. Now this one's crushed down the line. Hooking. Foul ball. Kicks and deals. Gets a piece there. We'll do it again. And a payoff pitch. And a foul ball. He stays alive. Good plate appearance there. Able to take the walk.
Oh, very close with the location right there. It's just tough to get rewarded on the call with pitches near the top of the strike zone.
Here's a 1-1. Check swing, no appeal.
Really good check swing right there. So difficult to hold off on the slider from a same.
Runner on the goal. Base knock, center field. Throw back in quickly. First and second now with nobody out.
Well, patience and discipline paid off right there as he got into an advantage count. That's about as textbook as it gets. Got his stride load out of the way early. He stayed inside that ball and squared it up out front. Man, that was like he was in the cage hitting off a tee.
New pitcher for the White Sox, Kai Bush.
And this could be a pretty critical point in this game. They're hoping he's the guy to keep them within striking distance.
And now the center fielder, Harrison Bader. He's already homered here in this one. Out towards right center field. Sheets under it. And there's one down. And now big number 99, Aaron Judge. Outfield playing very deep, not wanting anything over their heads. Ball to strike. The pitch.
Good spot for the hitter. Definitely has the advantage in this count with runners on. Look for him to be aggressive on this next pitch.
2-1 on Judge. And that one missing low.
Well, all eyes on the double play ball in this spot. No better way to get out of this inning.
Next offering is in for a strike. And they're all loaded up.
Well, the stage has been set for this offense, Boog. It's all about creating opportunities, and this is one of them right here.
So bases loaded with one away. In now is the Yankees DH, Giancarlo Stanton. Next pitch misses, and it's 2-1.
I think ultimately you want to tie him up, get the ball in on the plate so that he can't get the barrel to it and hit it to the outfield.
That's a little bit low.
Way to lay off that pitch down.
Diving, and he can't make the play. One runs in. Tag, but he's in there.
Well, that was an important at bat in this game, so great job there stepping up to the challenge. Absolutely punished that pitch. Wasn't fooled in the slightest. 109 off the bat. I think that means you put a pretty good swing on it.
The next offering misses. 2-1. Still only one out here in the inning. Next offering upstairs. And there's ball four.
You get a walk, and you get a walk. Everyone gets a walk, Boog.
Here's Gleyber Torres, who's 0 for 2 with a pair of strikeouts. The pitch. Good eye right there.
Boog, in situations like these, the air can get really thin up there at the plate. Got to find a way to breathe and slow everything down.
That's outside. And now three balls and a strike. The pitch. Next offering popped in the air, right field. Sheets puts it away. Runner tags for home. Throw is offline, and he scores. It's 5-0.
Well, that's the third run of the inning, and these guys are doing a nice job of executing at the plate right now.
Now he gets away from Grandal. And the runners will move up. Two one now. Just off the inside edge. Second and third, two down. And a swing and a line drive at a right field. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. And that is that. Here on the south side, bottom of the sixth. Stepping in, the White Sox leadoff man, Andrew Benintendi. Swing and a miss. Now 1-2.
It really looks like these hitters have been in between with their timing today. Good fastball, excellent slider, but they've not been able to commit to one velocity and stay there. I always remember watching Johan Santana pitch, and when he was in his prime, you would see a lot of guys out in front, right-handers pulling that changeup in the stands and then fouling the fastball the opposite field up into the stands.
Ground ball up the middle, Torres. And Benintendi is out.
Well, he's doing a nice job of keeping the ball out of the air. Lets the defense work behind him with another ground ball. Good execution.
Anderson tries to hold up, appeal to first, and Gary Simmons punches him out. That's a strikeout. Two outs, base is empty. Eloy Jimenez now. Now fly ball to right center. Judge is there. He's there. He's got it. And that's the third out. And welcome back. New inning getting started. Leading off, Jose Trevino. Got it by him for the K. Oswaldo Cabrera stepping in now for the Yankees. The switch hitter batting right. The big lefty turns, kicks, deals. The punch out there, and there's two down. Here's the shortstop at the plate. Isaiah Kiner-Falefa, one for two. The pitch. Check swing, no appeal, and a count 2-1. That one missed. That's towards center. Squeezes it, and that is the third out of the inning. Back at Guaranteed Rate Field, here's the center fielder, Luis Robert. And a pitch.
You know, he's been so great today, really just throwing whatever the catcher puts down. I mean, hasn't shaking off the catcher very much at all today.
And now it's filled up. And a 3-2. Gets a piece and stays alive. Three balls, two strikes, the count. Stays alive. 3-2 now. Fights it off, you'll see another.
Also really good at bat. What I like about this guy, his bat stays in the zone for a long time. Gives him the ability to foul off tough pitches.
Swing and a miss, and he is down on strikes for the third straight at bat. Gavin Sheets steps to the plate for the White Sox. Next one misses, and it's 2-1. This to third. Throw on to Rizzo. Two up, two down.
Well, we're clearly at that point in this ball game with the no-no going that we're anticipating seeing some history. Those infielders right now, they are on their toes expecting the ball to be hit today.
Ground ball, Rizzo picks it up, takes it himself. Play made, that ends the inning. We're at the top of the eighth. Now the number two hitter, Harrison Bader. Kicks and fires.
Two balls, One strike.
And he swings and lifts one to deep center field. That's back there. And it's gone! Harrison Bader leaves the yard. He's done it again. His second homer of the game. It's 6-0. Now it's Aaron Judge up to the plate. Oh, can't pick it up cleanly. But the throw to first gets him easily. And that's the first out. Now here's Giancarlo Stanton. 1-for-3. Next one is off the play. And that's ball two. They say it went.
2 balls, 2 strikes.
And now 2-2. Swings and misses. It's a strikeout. Chase the fastball up the ladder for strike three. Two outs, bases empty. Anthony Rizzo stepping in now for the Yankees. Misses outside. Now 2 balls and a strike. Out towards left center. Benintendi moving under it. Makes the play, and it's out number three. Ready for the bottom of the eighth. Yasmani Grandal up to hit. And this lineup is still hitless as we begin the eighth. The next pitch misses. Ball three.
I can't play around with him here. It's a 6-run lead at this point. Got to attack hitters even if you give up a solo shot.
Next offering, pop foul off to the right out of play. The wind of the pitch. That one misses, so a leadoff walk.
Well, he's normally going to fill up the strike zone and really limit base runners, but his command in this one just seems off out there. A lot more walks than he's used to giving up.
The 1-1. Swing and a foul straight back.
If you're going to get something going, this is the time to do it. You get the leadoff man on. Everybody's got to look over the shoulder and say, I'm just going to keep the line moving. Don't try to do too much.
Next pitch misses, and the count is filled up. At the belt and fires. Keeps the at bat going with a foul ball. The White Sox yet to pick up a hit here. Swings and misses. Some high cheese for strike three. Man at first, digging in, Hanser Alberto. Little trouble with this one behind the plate. And the runner stays where he is. And the 3-1. Now a screamer into the outfield. And there's two away.
Man, he's getting really close to this thing right now. Only four outs left, but it's going to be tough to get.
Back to the top of the White Sox lineup. Benintendi to the plate. The 1-1 is fouled off. And the pitch. That one misses. The count now 2-2. Yeah, that's outside.
Great RBI spot here. Just got to stay focused on the pitch. The runner will be in motion, so something in the gap should definitely score it.
Into center. Bader sizing it up. And the inning is over. Welcome back. We go to the ninth. Gleyber Torres up to hit.
Gleyber Torres.
The wind of the pitch. And now 2 balls and a strike. That's to third. In time to Vaughn. And they get the leadoff man of the ninth. Now it's LeMahieu up to hit. The 1-2. Swing and a ball lined out towards center. He's got it, and there's two away. Two outs, base is empty. And here's the catcher, Jose Trevino. Payoff pitch. In the air, right field. Sheets trots over to his left, and that'll do it. Tommy Canley comes on now.
Compared to some days, this is a pretty low leverage appearance for him, so he should be fairly free and easy out there. Still have to keep yourself sharp and attack the strike zone.
And now the shortstop, Tim Anderson. Everyone's attention on the no-hit bid now. Three tough outs to get.
Can only imagine the nerves that some of the defensive players have right now. You've got to have the mindset, I want the ball hit to me, but in front of that, you hope that he strikes the hitter out.
That one down the line, and it goes just foul. Three outs from a no-hitter. That one lifted to left. Cabrera makes the play, and there's one down. Just two more outs to go in this bid for a no-hitter.
And physically, there's probably some fatigue, but mentally, which might be what's most important, he seems as strong now as he's been all game.
I'm sure the adrenaline is fully ramped up at this point as well. Next offering is in for a strike. The 1-1 is fouled off. And that one hammered. That's going back. Back some more. And it's gone. A home run to break up the no-hitter. He powers that one out to left. And they're on the scoreboard. It's 6-1. And next will be the cleanup hitter, Luis Robert. Righty delivers. Out to short, Connor Falefa. Slings it across. White Sox down to their final out.
It's a good recovery, though, after giving up the home run. Not allowing it to stay in the head, but going to work at the next hitter. And a tough one at that.
Left-hand hitter waits. Off the plate inside, two balls and a strike. That one ripped, but foul. Down to their final strike. And that just misses.
That turns out to be a really good take right there, but you don't want to end this game with the bat on your shoulder.
Swing and a ball lifted in the air, left field, pretty well struck. That one back there. Out of here! Gavin Sheets goes deep, and they slice into the lead. It's 6-2.
Always scary for a pitcher when a guy can take a fastball down the middle and hit it to the opposite field. No holes in a swing like that, and that time that ball was hit hard.
New pitcher for the Yankees, Ian Hamilton.
And we all know about his slider. It's just filthy, man, and one of the better ones in the game, I'd say. Spin rate's very high, and it just breaks a ton.
Andrew Vaughn steps to the plate for the White Sox. Next offering is fouled back. And the right-hander deals. Spoils a two-strike pitch, and he'll see another. That misses the zone. Two balls, two strikes to count with two outs. on the ground. Torres handles. On to first. Ball game.
This was by no means an offensive outburst. Only four hits the entire game, but good teams find a way to win, and they did.
And your final, 6-2. For Chris Singleton and our entire crew, I'm John Ciambi, saying so long from the south side of Chicago.
Our final line score tonight, first for the victorious Yankees, six runs, four hits, no errors. They left two men on base.